Hey, June. You hanging in there?
Oh, well, I guess so. Every day I get up and tell myself, you just have to get through today.
Now, you've been through a rough time, man. The worst. Just, let me know if there's anything I can do to help.
Oh, okay. Yeah, hey, I know I haven't been pulling my weight around here, and I'm really trying to do better. Okay?
Come on, there's nothing to apologize for. You worry about you, and everything will take care of itself.
Okay. Thanks, Sturgis. Thanks for checking in on me.
Of course. We look out for our own. Always.
Thank you. Sorry about that. I had my mic off. What's up?
Ah, nothing, man. Morning.
Quite literally morning. I haven't been to bed. How are you? Nope. No, dude. I haven't been to bed yet. Dude, I'm an insomniac. I don't have a choice. I have been an insomniac for 12, 13 years now. I don't have any control over when my body falls asleep. Oh, yeah, of course it's not good. Why do you think I was in the hospital last month for like 3 weeks? My body literally was shutting down on me because I wasn't getting enough sleep. Well, I'm used to it. They give me some medication, try to handle it and deal with it. Nothing new. Alright. Yeah, I'm building my house right now. And I'm like being like OCD as fuck with it. I'm like, ugh, there's something missing. I was like, okay, I want a second floor balcony. Alright, there it is. Took that corner out, put that in there. Now I'm looking up at the front entrance right here, and it's just, god damn, I hate this right there. It's just, but then it doesn't look right. Maybe I'll just leave that open like that. Even though that's, there's nothing I can do about that stair right there. That's just how it's gonna be. And now I'm trying to think, how do I want to do that up there? I've got an idea. I want to see if I can do it. I don't think I can, but I'm going to try. If I can get up the fucking stairs. Alright, so let's take these out. Alright, I don't think this is going to work, but I'm going to try it anyways. Huh, it does work. Weird. I was not expecting that to work. It's just an aesthetic appearance. That's all I really want. I'm not actually going to use it. It's for aesthetics. Me and my OCD.
I like it.
Are you sure? Fucking piece of shit. Goddamn, gotta take the goddamn roof off just to put that fucking thing on. And watch, this isn't gonna clip in now. Oh, thank god. Alright, now let's go look at it from the outside. It just looked really, really flat in the front. Yeah, I like that much better now. Obviously, it needs to be filled in and all that shit.
Okay. Looks really, really good so far.
So far, yep. Goodbye, stairs. You want to know what's going to be on the roof? My helipad landing. That's why I've got the three-level elevator, because it's going to go all the way up to the roof, so it'll take me up to the roof. I know, right? Dude, I saw somebody build a fucking underground bunker with, like, he had a four-step elevator, and the fourth top of it was actually on the surface, like the ground level, like this right here, It was on ground level, and then when you went in, it took you all the way down to the basement of it. And in the basement, he had this whole fucking shrine of fucking weapons and armor all around him. It was like his little man cave. It was fucking sweet. I saw it, I was like, oh, I want to do that so bad. I think it's the Vault-Tec thing, because I think the only way you can do that is with the Vault-Tec. Yeah, it was pretty cool. I was jelly. Very, very jelly.
But yours is working out pretty good.
Yeah. It's getting there. My problem right now is I'm out of screws. Is she... Yeah, she's not here either, so I can't buy them. So if I want more screws, I'm gonna have to go to the diner. I was messing around with how to auto farm in the game. I figured it out, but you can't do it with every single place because you have to make sure that when you're auto farming. Like, let's say you want to farm adhesive. So you need mute fruit, corn, and potatoes. So you basically need an entire farm dedicated to just farming those three things. They don't do anything else. They don't do scavenging. They don't do any extra water more than they need for population. And you set up a production line connected to your and anytime those three things get put into the assembly line will pull them out and then send them into the production area where they can be like ready to be turned into like adhesive. Obviously it won't do it itself, but what that does is because every I think it's every 24 to 48 hours so much food whatever you're farming on your farm. Like, whatever farm it is or whatever it is that you're getting, so much of the percentage of that food is automatically put into that thing, into that workbench, without you having to do it yourself. It's always done that. It just doesn't do it in big gulps. It's like, let's say you have, for instance, I've got 36 potatoes on the Abernathy farm right now. Every 24 to 48 hours, somewhere between 6 to 12... will go into there. And that's 24 to 48 hours game time, not real life. So basically anywhere between 6 to 12 out of those will go in there every day to every other day. Once you go back to Abernathy Farm, the assembly line, because it only works when you're there, will turn on and start pulling all that stuff out of the thing and get prepped for like that kind of stuff. Basically, make it so that even if you're away, or if you AFK at Abernathy, or wherever you decide to do it, you can AFK there, and like just turn your TV off, and then just go like to the movies or the store, or just leave it on running in the nighttime. The guy said he did it, and when he woke up in the morning, he had close to 2,000 of every single one of them. He had a little over almost 2,000 mute fruit and almost 2,000 corn. And just by leaving it on at night, and it was auto-farming it. Yeah, but it only works if you're physically there at the farm. It's doing it. Like, eventually it will hit the cap, and it will stop auto-farming into the workbench, but the assembly line won't pull out of the workbench unless you're physically at the assembly line, in the area nearby it. So, apparently that was kind of a way to make it so you couldn't just, like, because there, you could basically auto farm adhesive, ammo, all kinds of things in the game. Because I'm gonna start doing, I'm gonna put 10 scavenger benches at Starlight Drive-In, and then I'm also going to get 10 Brahmin. And by doing that, if I leave my game on for like 24 hours and I come back, I'll have. I think one guy, he did it. He had close to 3,000 .308 rounds. when he left his game running for 24 hours straight while he was there, it was his ammo assembly line. And when he did that, basically 24 hours later in real life, which was like, I guess, 3 or 4 months in the game, he had almost over 3,000 .308 rounds. Yeah. Because basically what happened was is the scavengers keep bringing back scavenge. Each one of them brings back one piece every single day. When they bring back one piece every single day, any of that which is steel or whatever the other material was to do that will get put into the assembly line and automatically get shipped over to the spot to where it needed to go through the assembly line. It would go into the ammo production facility factory, and then the fertilizer created from the Brahmin would go into the ammo production facility, and it would end up making 10.308 rounds every, I think he said it was like every 8 to 10 minutes or something like that. Or no, it was less than that. 3 to 5 minutes, it was making 10 to 20.308 rounds every 3 to 5 minutes. And he left it running for 24 to like 26 hours. I have to double check. I know my math's a little off somewhere in there. But he said basically he had literally just left it on, and he had enough ammo to last him for like a fucking 2 weeks in real life, just fucking doing nothing. Yeah, so he's like, if you know how to utilize it correctly, you can get a lot out of it, but you have to leave your game running to do it. Or you can get, like, if you just want to get your hands on, like, maybe 200 or 300 ammo for free, you basically just sit there for a couple hours and just, like, watch a movie or something, and then come back from AFK and you'll have, like, 200 or 300 rounds and you don't have to pay anything for it. Yep, and you can do that with any ammo in the game, as long as you have the right setup in order to farm enough stuff.
Yeah, but I don't think I'm going to leave my system
on for that long. Oh, PlayStation 4s are pretty damn durable, dude. Don't worry about that. I leave my PlayStation 4 on a lot.
Well, this...
Oh, that's understandable. Trust me, I can understand that. That's understandable. Yeah, I mean, even if you just make an assembly line and you just sit there and watch a movie for like an hour or two and then come back from being AFK, you'll still get something out of it. You just won't get like a shit ton like that guy did when he left his shit running for 24 hours. Yeah. That's still on? Why is that on? What the fuck? Weird. Alright, so the beacon's being powered by that. That's being powered by that. Okay, cool. So now I want to take this, grab this, I'm not sure how this is gonna work, we'll see. Okay, so it's on the bottom somewhere. I gotta figure out how I'm gonna do this. Cause I wasn't entirely sure where the power thing was. Ah, there it is. Which means... take this, put that there. Should be. Oh, it's still hitting that. Damn it. Okay, so what about if I do doctor switches? Ceiling. Like the way that's sitting, all the same. Am I hitting that still? Huh. That should be able to go through that. I don't know why it's not going through there. There's usually always a way to do this somehow, and I usually 9 times out of 10 can. I think I remember how I did stuff like this. This one should be a little bit simpler to do too, due to the fact that it's. Hoping it would reach it. I really want this damn thing to work, and it's being annoying. Thought of something. Huh. Go look at them apples. Sometimes it just takes the brain a while to figure it out, that's all. kind of just need to figure out how to get this power where I want it. The method is going to be a little funky no matter what I do. Damn thing was getting annoying. I've done this before, but I don't remember how the hell I did it. And that's the problem I'm having right now. Thank you. Yeah, this is one of the, I wouldn't say it's new, but it is one of the more newer ones. Actually, I think I want that one. Didn't want to do that. One that's upside down, not right side up. Right here, this one. There we go. Got it. It was only a matter of time before my genius worked.
It's taking video a little bit.
Obviously, this isn't going to be the final product. I'll end up redoing this entire thing again. But, voila! So, I don't know if you saw it though, but I'll just take the wall out and show you what I did. Alright. Basically, that's the power to the elevator there. Connected it to this wall passing through conduit. Went up here into the base of the second floor. Put a snake pipe on and then an outdoor conduit connector. Boom, done. And I figured it out. Voila.
That's pretty ingenious. I don't know how much you call it. Pretty ingenious strategy. Like, live stuff. You should have been like...
Second floor, anybody? Ooh, I don't like that. Why is that sitting there? It's sitting like that. I'm a numbskull. I'm an idiot. Well, you learn from your mistakes, ladies and gents. Maybe it doesn't. Why is the elevation off so badly for that? Elevation on that is way off. I mean, what? Have that gap right there. That doesn't make any sense. Why is there a gap there? I don't like that. Why is it doing that? Gonna do this just so I can use the elevator. Figure this out. Okay, so, but here's the thing though. I don't know why it does this, but look right there. I mean, you'll see it in a minute what I mean. It doesn't line up correctly and it leaves a gap in it now. Unless we're not supposed to use these walls with it. With the elevator. Yeah, you're not supposed to use those walls with it. The elevator is warehouse walls. See, I was thinking I could get away with it as a house wall, not a warehouse. I wanted to use it in my house. Now that was the problem. Because the regular house walls don't go that high. But the warehouse ones do. There we go. I could just use the warehouse ones. That's fine. My design isn't gonna get that screwed up by using the warehouse ones. Alright. Thank you. It's still doable. I can still figure this out. We still got this.
What you did with the doorways to the elevator, that's
cool. Yeah, we'll see here. We'll see if I actually like this or not. If not, then I'll just go. I'll just have to sacrifice the elevator for my house. Because if it ends up being more struggle than it needs to be. With it.
Well, instead of just being your house, you can have just a warehouse.
Mm-hmm. not letting me put my... piece back up again. It's nothing bad, it's just... Wheels are turning. None of these do what I was hoping for. I don't think I'm gonna be able to do this. Cause what I wanna do... Damn it. Oh well, so much for having an elevator in there. I was really looking forward to having an elevator. Okay, I can't do an elevator with normal. I mean, I could still do this. It's just what I want to do, like the design I want to do, I can't do it with this fucking pieces. Something like that. Problem is, this isn't much of a. The warehouse pieces just don't give a very housey feel. Which sucks. Thank you. It's getting there. not too bad.
Jeez Louise.